everyone, and welcome to Storytime with the Seatons.
As you can see, we look a little bit different today. We decided to get into character as the main character from our story.
So this week, our story is called The Sleepy Sloth.
Here he is.
Lost beneath the forest's tall trees, long branches gently sway in the breeze. Nature's finest, standing so proudly, rainforest wildlife stir loudly.
Canopy shelter the forest from above, protecting the landscape so many animals love. Tropical rain tumbles down to the ground, streams and waterfalls can be found.
Busy creatures are scurrying here and there, plant life is flourishing everywhere. The hustle and bustle of the rainforest day and night, every living species up for the fight.
All bar one, however, he thinks he's the most clever.
Draped over the same branch of a tall tree, wallowing and basking, he's as happy as can be. This large, lazy critter sits all day long, refusing to help, never believing he's wrong.
Big round head sits on top of his hairy round belly. He's far too idle to care if he's smelly.
Huge vacant eyes stare into the distance. His clear loneliness is no coincidence. Curved pointy claws help him hang so high. He smirks contently, heaving a heavy sigh.
Then one day, as he lay still and calm, he slowly stretched out his long furry arm. The sun beamed through the leaves so green. He steadily shuffled so as not to be seen. A terrified toucan crashes into his tree.
Help! Help!
He calls.
Please save me! The sleepy sloth lazily raised his head.
Can I really be bothered to get out of my bed?
The toucan flapped and flapped, but it was no use. He was never going to shake himself loose. The sloth's claws could easily break him free.
But why should I move?
He thought.
It's just not me.
All of a sudden, the branches snapped. The terrified toucan no longer trapped. He tumbled and tumbled until he hit the deck. Now his beautiful wings were a terrible wreck.
He wearily hobbled until out of sight. How awful to fall from such a terrible height. Meanwhile, the sleepy sloth just sits unnerved, as long as his branch remains preserved.
Draped over the branch of a tall tree, wallowing and basking, he's as happy as can be. This large, lazy critter sits all day long, refusing to help, never believing he's wrong.
The days go by, this creature remains so still, alone and undisturbed, is his only thrill. Reluctantly, he clambers towards a branch of figs, sliding across long, narrow twigs.
Hunger the only thing forcing him to budge. Dragging his body, he gives it a nudge, eventually clasping it between his claws. Now out of energy, he stops to pause.
Finally, he's able to consume his prize. Feeling full, he slowly closes his eyes. A day's work is far beyond his powers. He'd rather much lay around in the sun for hours.
Draped over the branch of a tall tree, wallowing and basking, he's as happy as can be. This large, lazy critter sits all day long, refusing to help, never believing he's wrong.
The warm sun has now faded away. Sleepy Sloth still snores at the end of the day. After 17 hours, he eventually wakes in the dead of night. The branch gently shakes.
Stars now fill the pitch black skies as nocturnal life begins to rise. Spiders, insects, birds and bats all appear from their habitats.
Busily working through the night, back and forth with all their might. Sleepy Sloth just sits up without any cares.
Why waste my energy?
He smugly declares.
Suddenly he spots an army of ants carrying leaves from the tropical plants. Marching along a nearby branch, Sleepy Sloth realises this is his chance.
Sliding along, creeping and crawling, using his claws to stop him from falling, the leafy ant train just walks on past. If only he was just as fast.
Moments later, the rest of the ant train appears in front of him carrying leaves again. Extending his arms, he grabs the leaves one by one, piling them high until the ants have none.
Without a thought for the hungry ants, he scoffs down the tropical plants. As long as he's happy and fed, he couldn't care less what anyone said.
Once full, he returns to laying so still, dreaming and drooling as he digests his meal.
Draped over the branch of a tall tree, wallowing and basking, he's as happy as can be. This large, lazy critter sits all day long, refusing to help, never believing he's wrong.
Then one night, as the moon shone high, lightning strikes to light up the sky. Thunder echoes and booms all around. Large raindrops begin to tumble to the ground.
Canopies can no longer take the weight of the storm. A tropical monsoon is about to be born.
Hurricane winds attack the trees.
Rain lashes down against the leaves.
Wildlife scampers to find a safe place.
Hiding and surviving becomes a race.
Sleepy Sloth wakes in a dreary state.
Too slow and lazy to prevent his fate.
Digging his claws in and lying on his back, his lonely branch begins to snap and crack. Hanging on to prevent an almighty fall, he suddenly realises how he's been so cruel.
Tears run down his furry face, if only he had friends to help his case. Then out of nowhere, a creature appears. Sleepy Sloth tries to wipe away his tears.
Standing tall, the creature slowly moves in. The elusive jaguar is now staring at him. Sleepy Sloth braces himself for the terrifying roar, but the jaguar just hands out a helpful paw.
Pulling him to safety, away from danger, how will he ever thank his heroic stranger? Slowly the warm sun reappears, wildlife everywhere let out huge cheers.
Sleepy Sloth realises he should have been a better friend. More of a helping hand he could have lent. Being alone isn't really that fun. The beautiful rainforests need to be shared by everyone.
Draped over the same branch of a tall tree, wallowing and basking, he's as happy as can be. This large, lazy critter sits all day long, alongside the jaguar, a friendship so strong. The end.
We hope you enjoyed the story today of the Sleepy Sloth.
Thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel and follow us on Instagram at Storytime with the Seatons to find out more about any stories that might be coming up. Thank you very much. Bye bye.
See you soon.